Well, wouldn't you know, I just remembered that I had a dream last night. In fact, it woke me up at 4:30. It was the most extraordinary dream. And it sort of slipped my mind functioning today at work. And suddenly now it comes back, oh my gosh, I need to share this. It's just absolutely amazing. How to make a long story short, but basically, I came across this, I seemed to be walking, and I seen suddenly this dancer, this female dancer, and there was a man there too, like her brother or something, or some relationship, maybe her manager or something, I don't know, but this dancer began dancing, and it was the most incredible dancing, and it really enthralled me. It pulled me in like hypnotically and enthralled me. I was just like, I couldn't believe that the dancing was so enthralling, and I felt myself being pulled into this and completely forgetting everything else. It was incredible. And then I woke up, and I thought about it. And I believe I've finally been able to, I was able to get some clarity about the whole situation. This dancer was literally dancing the dance of biological life. Biological. The dance of biology, the dance of chemistry, the dance of physics, the dance of nature. It was the dance of nature. She was dancing this dance of nature. The man with her was the mind, symbolized the mind. And she was what she really was, though, was a programmed robot. Okay, and the mind had done all the programming. Okay. And so in the morning, I was still feeling this enthrallment, and then I switched my mind. I switched over and I said, instead of addressing the dancer, trying to struggle with it, I turned to the man there, and I said, you know, sir, you know, what a great job you have done programming this dancer. What a marvelous job. How enthralling this dancer is. You're so faithful to the idea that I gave you. Now I'm going to give you a different idea to present to me. So bravo to this idea. Indeed, it was entirely enthralling. What a marvelous job. This totally shifted the focus off of the dance and the dancer and put myself in charge of the whole situation. And it was like a miraculous type of change. Gone was the enthrallment. Gone was the enthrallment. And so this shows that the videos that I've been producing the last several, talking about to thank the mind for being faithful to the idea that we gave it and presenting such an incredibly effective scenario of prepping for time, to put the focus on thanking the mind and addressing the mind directly. Do not struggle with the programming that the mind has given, with the robotic dance of nature that the mind has programmed. Don't even address that at all. Just smile and say to the mind, what an amazing job you did. Yes, indeed, that was very enthralling. But now I'm addressing you directly, mind, and I'm saying, guess what? I'm giving you a new idea to present. And I know that your faithfulness to the idea, that previous idea, proves you'll be faithful to the next idea, no matter what you may say at this point, because that's still part of presenting the other idea. Doesn't matter. I know you've been very faithful. So there was this confirmation in the dream of this dynamic that I've been speaking about. And I'm telling you, it was amazing, because the dance was just completely absorbed, was pulling my attention in, like into a hypnotic trance. So I was as if I was forgetting myself. Coming completely forgetful of myself, and only my attention 100% was being absorbed by the dancer and the dance, and nothing else outside of that existed at all. I felt myself going to that point, and then I remembered, oh no, there's another person standing there who's not dancing at all, and I need to keep the picture wide enough. So, you know, I remember that, but I was forgetting it. So the answer is, again, to see, oh, there's a dance of nature, isn't totally enthralling, but I'm going to compliment the one that is producing this enthrallment, which is the mind, not dancing. So this was a miraculous, it is the way, it's a confirmation that this is the way, this is the miraculous way that breaks the spell of nature. Mind tells us that nature is God's creation, which is, again, another lie. That's part of the enthrallment, because then if it's God's creation, we think we have to, that having our intention completely absorbed by nature must be the right thing, right? And we just need to learn how to embrace Mother Earth more, with all this death and impermanence and disaster, etc. That somehow that's God's gift to us or something. That's part of mind spiel, you know, that it's marketing to us. And we, instead of struggling with that, instead of fighting against anything, don't resist anything. Just smile and turn to mind and say, "Mind, what a beautiful job you've done. Thank you so much for being so faithful." That puts you in control. You're in a positive state. You're blessing, you're thanking, you're positive. You're not resisting anything. And you're simply tell mind, "I'm here. Now I'm giving you a new idea to present to me. So here you go." And there's no back talk. There's no, you're not asking. You don't say, "Mind, do you mind if I give you another idea? Or can I give you? Can I give you?" You don't say, "Can I give you?" You say, "Mind, here is the next idea that I'm going to, that you're going to present to me." And, all right, that's it. "Mind, here is the next idea you're going to present to me. This is going to be prepping to step into timelessness." You don't address anymore the effects of the previous idea, which is prepping to step into time. You don't. You acknowledge mind directly, not indirectly, not trying to work through nature at all. You don't try to do anything at all with nature. You're not trying to work through it. You're not trying to address nature. You're not trying to say, "Oh, mind, look. Look at this. I see that." No, just say, "Hey, mind," directly address mind. "Mind, thank you for this presentation. And now here is the idea that will be your new presentation." Very great. Easy. Just like that. The more businesslike, the better. This is really the key. And this stunning, stunning dream showed me that this dynamic. I was able to sort it out. It wasn't easy. Because the thraldom was off the charts, literally. It was feeling like you're just being, your attention is just, everything else is just going away as if it never was. You know, you're just losing track of where I was. I forgot all about who I was, where I was, all that stuff. It seemed to vanish. It was vanishing, amazing. So this is a milestone. It was the morning of June 6th. The morning of June 6th, this clarification of the whole dynamic and how to get free of this enthralldom to this prepping for time, which is what we call nature. Life. We call it life. It's not life. It's a dance designed to prep us for stepping into time, which of course there's no such thing as time, so time will never start, we'll never step into it. So on June 6th, 2013, the morning of June 6th, interestingly, this is also the date of D-Day, I don't know how many years ago, but it was close to 70 something years ago? The D-Day, and it's also 6-6, and then 2-1-3, 2 and 1 is 3, plus 3 is 6, so you could say it's 6-6-6. And the news today is incredible. It's all coming out suddenly. Kaboom! Kaboom! And what's even more amazing is that nobody really cares. There's just a few small amount of people that are sounding the alarm. The rest of the people, they really can't, not even, relating to anything that's going on, which essentially is, guess what, people? the New World Order, the Brave New World, the Orwellian dystopia. It's here. Basically, the packaging has come off now, and everybody is now subject to being spied upon. No more really true privacy. No more freedom. It's suddenly to poof, you know, just like that. We realize that this has been going on for a long time, and you're June 6, 2013, 66666. So it is very apropos that this dream also arose, and I was able to see the real mechanism of salvation, the real mechanism of repentance of salvation, which is address mind directly. That's the one thing that mind tells you not to do. It says, no, that's taboo. Absolutely taboo. And mind insists that's blasphemous. Utterly blasphemous. How dare you, address me directly. You don't know what you're doing. You go crazy. All this stuff. Mind tries to put some total fear into you to address it directly. And it tells you, no, you can only speak to nature, but not to me directly. Whereas, the spiritual path is difficult because you're working against that absolute taboo, the one and absolute taboo that mind tells you. Because, of course, as soon as you address mind directly, you tell it, now you're going to present prepping for timelessness to me. That's it. Then mind has to comply with that, has to comply. So, of course, when we present mind to tell us, mind make us prime creator, mind has to scare us into maintaining this idea forever, because there is no success with it. So the only success we can have is the idea of we're still holding on to it. That's the only success we have, is, oh, well, at least we're still holding on to it. So mind tells us that in order to get this, we're still holding on to it. It tells us you can never address mind directly. It's utter blasphemy, utter blasphemy. You're blaspheming God, all this stuff. It will try to intimidate you that way. But it's too late now, it's been seen. So I was not intimidated by the mind like that. I said, no, mind, now here is your next assignment, which is to prep me for timelessness. So right on time with this sudden, there's an awakening happening in the world. That we realize, oh my gosh, all the stuff we worried about has happened. All the things we were warned about, they've happened. We're in it. It is exactly what we thought would happen, is happening in the world. And there is this, we're essentially living in a police state, a dictatorship police state. And nobody's making any apologies for it either. No, that's not even paying any attention to the complaints. So, at the same time, the realization of how to get free of this, how to sidestep it all, arrives, which is to address mind directly and say, thank you, mind, for this horrible dystopian fascist police state dictatorship that you've so wonderfully and artfully have arranged, and being so completely faithful to my instructions that you try to find a way to make me prime creator, and therefore you've been prepping me to step into time, which would be annihilation, and then I telling me that I'll be resurrected from that, and everything you've done, mind, is perfect, shows your perfect faithfulness to this idea. Therefore, I trust you completely to be perfectly faithful to this new idea I'm giving you to prep me for timelessness. So here you go. Here is your new assignment, mind. Addressing mind directly and not asking for its permission. You're not asking for mind's permission for anything. You're telling mind, this is its next assignment. That is reality. That is reality. God doesn't say, spirit, can I do this? Can I get your permission to do this? Or spirit doesn't say to mind, oh, mind, what would you like me to do? Or can you tell me what to do? No, spirit is the one who chooses for mind and says, just like God chooses for spirit, spirit chooses for mind, as it were. It says, mind, this is the idea I'm giving you. There's no asking. Spirit is the causation is at the level of causation as far as choosing ideas goes. It chooses what the production's going to be, and then the mind produces it. So, the mind chooses how to produce it in its infinite creativity, but it does not select what the theme is, the idea is. So again, the goal is to address mind directly and get past that taboo. So that's what we're aiming for here. And not a minute too soon, because mind is really pulling out all the stops to make this prepping for time very, very, very intense. And to show just how faithful it is to pursuing this lunatic agenda, and how it's going to just absolutely get super heavy-handed with no apologies whatsoever and stonewall everything. That's all part of this dance that mind is putting on for us, this dance. And so what we do, we don't resist it. We say, thank you, mind. What a wonderfully dystopian future you have prepared for us. Thank you very much. And now, here is your next assignment, which is to present Prepping for Timelessness for me. Game over. It's not a game changer. It's checkmate. It's not check. We're not looking to check the mind. We're looking to checkmate the mind. So we've just checkmated the mind. Checking gives it wiggle room. Too many teachings give, just check the mind. Let's check the mind. Let's check it. No, checkmate the mind. Checkmate the mind is where we're at now. We have no more time to play games with the mind, to let it maneuver. Because its maneuvering is, it's trying to teach us. It's trying to teach us how to be annihilated. And we don't enjoy that at all. We don't enjoy that, these lessons at all. Nobody does. People are saying, this is terrible, what's going on? But they don't have a clue what the remedy is. They don't have a clue. You listen to these people and they're shouting, oh my gosh, you know, fire, 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 fire. And they don't know where the exits are. So they're just panicking. Everybody's just panicking. They have no clue where the exit is. So basically the attitude is now going to grow like crazy. What we're having in the future coming up is people, their attitudes will just be, oh my God, fire, 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 fire is coming. We're on fire. This is fire. It's like, you know, it's like a that kind of panicky sort of, oh my gosh, you know, is that, that's like that magnitude and that intensity. Like we're in a trapped room and the room's on fire. That's the kind of emotionalism that's going to come now. We're in a trapped room, it's on fire, and we don't have a clue where the exits are. We're just banging the walls. And then the people are going to get into that. That's why I've been pushing on these videos for so long, so intensely, knowing that this is going to happen, is you can easily get caught up into panicking and just beating on the walls. Like, let's say these cinder block walls, right? There's a fire in the room, and you're just pounding your fists, and what are you doing? You're breaking your hands, you're breaking your bones, you're spanging your head, you're sobbing, going hysterical and all that stuff, because you don't know where the exit is. You don't know where the exit is. So that is now upon us. It is now upon us. Fortunately, we know where the exit is. Having foreseen all of this, putting right focus into the situation, we now can just easily say thank you, mind, for producing this cinder block room and producing this fire in the cinder block room and having us trapped in the cinder block room. And that's absolutely wonderful. What great faithfulness to the idea that I gave you. And now, here's your new idea. Prep me for timelessness. And then, boom, like that. No more room, no more fire, no more danger. And the exit door, suddenly there's the exit door. It's like, oh my gosh, simple as can be, it's no problem. That is the remedy. And, you know, those who know this are fortunate indeed right now. And I've done everything I can do. I've you know, made this all available, Creative Commons. Anybody can watch it. Anybody can share it. And what more can I do? You can't force people to listen to this or accept it at all. But I've stuck to my guns saying, this is valuable information because the times are going to get us like a trap. and drive us into this panicked mode where we just start ineffectually becoming just wailing ineffectually. Just wailing ineffectually. There's a point where you... And I can feel it now, that people are overwhelmed now by the magnitude of all the stuff, the tyranny that's going on. They're just kind of like saying, oh my gosh, we can't stop it. Oh my gosh, we can't stop it. And they're just becoming almost like apathetic too. Just like, oh God, I have no idea what to do. Maybe I'll just take my Percocet or something, you know, or drink more or whatever. And you can get caught into that. You can get caught into self-medication, all these things now. You could get caught into, whereas we're saying, oh no, the exit door is very simple. We know exactly what it is. Thank you, mind. Thank you, mind. Thank you, mind, for producing such an incredibly, wonderfully atrocious scenario, which is exactly what I asked you to do, really. And look, thank you for being 100% faithful to this miserable idea that I gave you. And now, I trust in your faithfulness, and I know your functionality is perfect, so I'm going to, here's your new idea. Boom. Okay. So, I always had this attitude that I'm going to escape these things, and so, you know, like sort of a feeling like I'm above all the worldly stuff, it's not going to touch me, because of this knowledge that this is the key. This is the key that opens the door, that opens the exit door. Just simply give mind a new idea. Choose a new idea. Say, here, mind, here you go. Here's your new idea. Game over. Simple as that. You're not negotiating with mind. This isn't Priceline. You're negotiating something with mind. Like, how much are you going to give me, mind? No, there's no negotiation. There's no discussion. You are in charge. You simply say, mind, your next idea, starting right now, is to present prep for timelessness. And no discussion. That's it. That's all. You just directly convey what this new idea is. So we're working towards that. There's some kind of threshold of will that we cross, that then mind begins to present this, because it knows that you are serious about this. This is actually, you're actually giving mind this mandate to do this. So we're working towards crossing that threshold at this point. And again, we better get it quick. Better get it quick, because again, mind scenario's on the march. Prepping for time is on the march. Really on the march. And bravo, you know. You should, instead of being all furious, we should be cheering. Say, bravo, mind. Tour de force, thank you. Clapping and say, what a, I knew you would come through mine and be faithful to this hideous idea I gave you. Look how monstrous it is now. Oh, wonderful mind. Now, here's your new idea. So we have to get to the point where we trust that mind is indeed following through on what we've been warned about, what it's going to do. We've been warned that this is coming, that this is terrible situation is coming. And here it is. Here it is. It's unfolding like the carpet is now rolling out the red carpet. You know, and welcoming the dictatorship. It's just like, you know, here we go again. Here we go again. Amazing. And as I know, so many people said, no, it won't happen. It won't happen. The Bible prophecy in the Bible is not true. It's not going to happen. Everything's going to be fine. And this is all just, you know, feverish fear-mongering. And now they're probably having second thoughts about that. The only problem is they didn't spend their time prepping to address mind directly. So now they're all struggling like indirectly and starting to panic. They don't know where the exit door is. So having faith in what we're told ahead of time is super important. The Holy Spirit said, look, believe this is going to happen. It's going to get bad. Believe it and start working towards that point so you can address mind directly. And those who had faith in that are certainly going to be saved from it, absolutely. So this day is a most momentous day where, oh my gosh, you know, we that the safeguards have been bypassed now, ruthlessly bypassed. And instead of being apologetic, they double down, which I've said in other videos, that what will happen is the mind will double down on everything and continue to double down. We're in a double down situation right now. Double down situation. Instead of saying, oh, I'm caught. You know, it's like a kid, a hand in a cookie jar, and they're caught red-handed. And instead of saying, I'm sorry, I was trying to get the cookies. They say, no. I was just protecting the cookie jar. I was just counting the cookies, make sure that nobody else takes any, you know. They just double down and then tell more lies and double down, double down, double down. So you have double downs. All this double downing happening now. And again, the attitude of doubling down is simply complete arrogance. That we're not doing anything wrong whatsoever. We're just, in fact, everything we're doing is incredibly great. Okay, again, thank you, mind, for being so deceptive. For being so duplicious, and thank you, mind, for being so arrogant and presenting this arrogant script here, this play. What a wonderful, what a wicked, wicked scenario you're presenting to us, exactly with great faithfulness and fidelity to the idea that we gave you to find a way to make us prime creator. Here's your new idea, mind. What a relief, mind, you're faithless now. Here's your new idea. Here it is. No ambivalence, no saying, no, make the idea that you have now, make it better for me, mind. That is the thing that messes us up. Don't even address that idea of making it better. Simply praise the mind for making it have always been perfect. See, mind, This presentation is perfect. It's flawless. Thank you very much. I know you're faithful. Now here's your new idea. You don't say, this what you've been doing, mine's so terrible. Please make it better. Can you not make it better for me? Don't complain, grumble, complain. Say, no. Bravo, mine. Bravo, bravo, bravo. What a great job you've done. How wonderful that you are still completely functional. I know you're completely functional, so I gotcha. Now here's your new idea, and you have no choice but to function perfectly with this new idea. So it's a gotcha time. We got the mind now. We got the mind exactly where we want it. Exactly where we want it. And yet, is the world reacting that way? I dare say not at all. I've searched the world over for this attitude, and can't find it. Just cannot find it. Instead, people say, oh, the planet's releasing their karma. We're working through some, you know, stuff and blah, 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 blah. That's not it. No. We're not working through anything. We're not releasing anything. Mind is just being totally faithful to the idea that we gave it. So, is the future dystopian? Of course. Of course it is. As it should be. That's fidelity to the idea we gave. Of course we're going to continue to try and teach ourselves and train ourselves how to die. Train spirit, we are spirit, trying to train spirit to die. And this mind will always be faithful to the idea we give it. And that's the idea we gave mind, to teach us how to die. Because in order to be prime creator, we have to die to what we are, which is spirit, not prime creator. We have to die to reality. And since reality is one indivisible whole, that means that all reality has to die. And for us, in order to accomplish this, so we're trying to learn how to die. And that's what mind is trying to train us for. That's what all this training, this is the staging, this is the training, this is the gym. The world is a gymnasium, this is the gym. The universe is a gym, we're in training. So thank the mind for what a lovely gym. What wonderful exercise equipment. What wonderful personal trainers. My gosh, how fantastic. Really getting this incredible workout. Thank you, mind, for setting this all up. Now, here's your new mandate, which is to set up prepping for timelessness. And that's it. You are in charge. Spirit is in charge. So this is what I tried to tell people long ago, and they just said I was just arrogant, or they couldn't even come up with a word. You know, you can't do that. I said, sure I can. Because you can't tell mind to present a new idea. You got to accept the idea that it's giving you. I say, I do accept it. That has done a perfect, flawless job, and now is my prerogative as spirit to give mine a different idea, because I have freedom to choose to experience any idea I want as spirit. We all do. And people look like, oh, you're so arrogant. You're crazy. How can you think these things? Et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Barbecue somewhere going on. Very nice. So, again, here we are in a wonderful position right now, because we say, I'm look at our wonderful mind. You're doing it. Yes, you are. You're doing it exactly as foretold, aren't you? Here comes the heavy hand. Here comes the fist. You know, here comes the fist. Here comes the hammer. Pound down all the nails. Perfect. 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 So, of course, this, you know, just changes. Checkmate. It's checkmate for mind. It is literally checkmate for mind. Here's your new idea, mind. And June 30th, I was told around that date, what's going to happen? Some relief. I don't know what the relief is. We can speculate. We can speculate. But some boost, relief, something that tells us, yes, this is exactly what you need to do. Yes, you can direct mind, address a mind directly. And yes, you can give it this new idea. And here is the showcase of this. Look how, look, this is what happens when you do this. We can get that. We may get it because we're ready for it and we're asking for it. Because when we, listen, when we tell mind, mind, here is your new idea to present to me. Prepping for timelessness. What does mind do then? See, this is exciting. This is what came to me this morning driving. I suddenly got it. What does mind do then? It presents us with the guru. It presents us with the one who is dwelling, who is perfectly prepped for timelessness, who is perfectly prepped, the perfect example. That's what mind does. That's what mind presents, because we told it to. So we very well could receive the presence of one who's perfectly prepped for timelessness and has accepted that. Perfectly, you know, we absolutely should, because we told time, and we told mind, here is your new idea. Addressed mind directly, mind, this is your new idea. This is prepping for timelessness. That's it. Now, immediately, mind gets its presentation going, and part of its presentation will very likely be a perfect example of what it's prepping you for. That helps you prep. So the help to prepare should now show up for us. It should show up for us. Which means that we're really in for a great ride now, that is for sure. So June 30th, we very well could come across someone in this world who is showcasing perfect preparation to step into timelessness, which will certainly be a revelation for us. It's like, oh wow, we really can do this. This is doable. This is, we can do it. Yes, we can. That's the real yes, we can. That's the real change. That's the real hope, and that's the real change. So how far away is that? That's like 24 days away, isn't it? 24 days away. See, now I see this possible, because we have directly addressed mind and given the mind the mandate. Now, here is your new idea. No more resistance on our part. That mind then has to immediately begin that presentation, and it will do it perfectly. We will be perfectly satisfied with how it does it, and that very well could include the presence of those who have accepted, who perfectly showcase this prepping for timelessness. Could be many, I don't know, but whatever mind does, it's going to be a perfect presentation for us. And so we are actually in the catbird seat at this very moment. We are in the catbird seat. that is. We are really in the catbird seat at this point. I believe that many of us waited until this point, I guess I did, to just make sure that mind was faithful to the idea we gave it. And now we can really say, oh my gosh, it is, it is. I had, you know, at least there was some little doubt maybe. But at this point, you say, oh, wow, no, no more doubt. It's really on. Thank you, mind. It's really on. All the players are on the stage, you know, and they're playing out this scenario just the way mind has scripted it for them. So at this point, I can say, okay, enough. That's I trust you, mind. Here, and here's your new mandate. Here's your new idea. And let that happen now. So again, we are in the catbird seat. Start to feel that relief. We are in the catbird seat. This knowledge is here now. This knowledge is here. The viewer knows that this knowledge is here. The simple way of directly addressing mind. No, don't address nature at all. Address mind directly. So mind, thank you. I trust you. Here's your new idea. Prep me for timelessness. And then the mind will do that perfectly. Salvation, liberation, freedom, sidestepping the troubles, all of that. Package deal, package vacation, as it were. So this is great news. This is the gospel, the good news. Great good news we have now. And it's too late for to stop it. It's already happened. The cat is out of the bag. And it won't be stopped. It won't be stopped. The checkmate has happened. And so the turnaround is bound to happen also. Presentation of prepping for timelessness, that is bound to happen now. So we can shift our attitude towards expectation for that. I can feel right now my attitude is literally turning around like 180 degrees. I was told to wait for this time. Wait until your attitude turns around, and then see what you want to do. See what you want to do now. So we will see. This is a great day. June 6th, 2013 is a great, great day. Thank you, mind, for bringing us this great day. Wonderful. Wow. Whew. Checkmate, 180 degree turnaround. Expectations now sky high. And whatever happens next is just going to be an outpouring of celebration, really. Mine is going to just do a fantastic job for us. All right. Celebrate. That's it for now. I'll get to work on something else, that's for sure. Here we go.